the questions, from the areas we touched in our previous classes. We talked about the two standard units of weight. We talked about the grams and kilograms. And we looked at how to convert from grams to kilograms and vice versa. We also established that 1,000 grams is equal to 1 kilogram. And in converting from grams to kilograms, we divide by 1,000. And from kilograms to grams, we multiply by 1,000. We looked at how to arrange values in grams and kilograms in order of size, where we looked at ascending order and descending order. Today, we'll be solving problems in this topic, grams and kilograms. I have an example on the board. Okay, let's look at this example on the board. How many grams are there in four boxes? Each box holding 150 grams. How many grams are there in four boxes? Each box holding 150 grams. Okay, we have that one box holds 150 grams. We have to find out how many grams that is four box holds. So we say four boxes hold 4 times 150 grams, and that will give us 600 grams by long multiplication. 150 times 4. 4 times 0 is 0. 4 times 5 is 20. Write 0, remember 2. 4 times 1 is 4 plus 2, we have 6. So 600 grams. How many grams are there in 4 boxes? Well, each box holds 150 grams. So we have that one box holds 150 grams. Then 4 boxes. Now give us 4 times 150 grams. That will give us 600 grams. How many 15 grams are there in 0.9 kilograms? How many 15 grams are there in 0.9 kilograms, 600 grams, and 1 over 5 kilograms? Now, from the first one, we see that we have grams. We have grams here and grams. So we don't need to convert anything, because we have the same unit. But here, we are asked how many 15 grams are there in 0.9 kilograms. How do we do that? We first convert this to grams, so we can now divide through. So we say, we know that 1 kilogram is 1,000 grams. So 0.9 kilograms to grams. Remember I said, when converting from kilograms to grams, we multiply by 1,000. So we say 0.9 times 1,000 grams. And that will give us 900 grams. We have a 0.9 times 1,000. It has 3 zeros, so we say 1, 2, 3. We have 900. We have 900 grams. So 0.9 kilograms is the same as 900 grams. So the question can now be said to be, how many 15 grams are there in 900 grams? So we converted this to grams and we got 900 grams. So you can now say, how many 15 grams are there in 900 grams? How do we do that? We said 900 grams divided by 15 grams. But to know how many 15 grams are 900 grams, we divide by 15. Okay, we can divide through, we have common factors. 5 into 15 will give us 3. Of course, this cancels this. 5 into 9, we have 1, remainder 4. We now have 40. 5 into 40, we have 8. And into 0, we have 0. 3 into itself is 1. 3 into 18. Alright, so we have 60 all over 1. And 60 over 1 will give us 60. So, how many 15 grams are there in 900 grams? We have 60 of them. We have 60 15 grams in 900 grams. We take it all over again. See? Take it all over again. How many 15 grams are there in 0.9 kilograms? And since we have different units, we convert our kilograms to grams. And by doing so, we multiply by 1,000. 0.9 times 1,000 gives us 900 grams. So 0.9 kilograms is the same as 900 grams. So the question cannot be rephrased to say how many 15 grams are there in 900 grams. So for us to do that, we divide by 15. 5 into 15 is 3. 5 into 9 is 1 remainder 4. You add up, it becomes 40. 5 into 40 is 8. It's 8. Then 8 is 0, we have our 0. So we now have 1 8 here. 3 into itself is 1. 3 into 18 is 6. There's no remainder. 8 is 0, we have 0. So if we divide 60 by 1, we have 60. So we can get 60 15 grams and 0.9 kilograms. Now the second one. How many 15 grams are there in 600 grams? How many 15 grams are there in 600 grams? For us to do that, we say 600 grams divided by 15 grams. 600 grams divided by 15 grams. We divide again, 5. Any number that ends with 5 or 0 is a multiple of 5. Must have been taught that in either grade 1 or 2. Any number that ends with 5 or 0 is a multiple of 5. So we can divide it by 5. 5 into 15, you have 3. 5 into 6, you have 1, remainder 1. Into 10, you have 2. And 0, you have 0. 3 into itself is 1. Into 12, we have 4. And 0, we have 0. 40 divided by 1, we have 40. So our answer is 40. So you can get 40, 15 grams. In 600 grams. The next one, we have 1.5 kilograms. How many 15 grams can we get from 1.5 kilograms? Since we have different units, we convert this to grams. We convert to grams. 1 kilogram is the same as 1,000 grams. So converts to grams. 1 kilogram is the same as 1,000 grams. How do we convert this to grams? We multiply by 1,000. Since it is a mixed number, we must have done types of fractions. We now convert it to improper fractions. 5 times 1 is 5, plus 1 we have 6. This gives us 6/5 times 1,000 grams. We convert our mixed number to improper fraction. So, at this point, we multiply through. 5 into itself is 1. Into 10 we have 2. 0 we have 0. And 0 we have 0. So this will give us 6 times 200 grams. Multiply to we get 1,200 grams. So our 1/1/5 kilograms, when converted to grams, we get 1,200 grams. So we can now say how many 15 grams are there in 1,200 grams. For us to do that, we say 1,200 grams divided by 15 grams. We divide through again, of course, this cancels this. 5 into itself is 5 into 15 is 3. 5 into 15 is 3. 5 into 12, we have 2 times with the remainder of 2. Into 20, we have 4. And 0, we have 0. 3 into itself is 1. Into 24, we have 8. And we have 0. So we have 80 divided by 1, which is 80. So we can get 80 15 grams in 1/1/5 kilogram. I said in doing that, since we have different units, we convert them to the same unit. In conversion of kilograms to grams, I said earlier we multiply by 1,000. So 1 kilogram is 1,000 grams. 1/1/5 kilograms to grams, we multiply by 1,000. Before we do that, see, this is a mixed number. Or a mixed fraction. This is a mixed number, we convert it to an improper fraction. By this, we see 5 times 1 is 5, plus 1, we have 6/5. 6/5, then times our 1,000. We multiply by 1,000. 5 into itself is 1, into 10 we have 2, 0 we have 0, and 0 we have 0. So we're now left with 6 times 200. If we multiply that, we get 1,200 grams. So our 1/1/5 kilograms is the same as 1,200 grams. So we now convert this. We have asked how many 15 grams are there? 1,200 grams. We divide by 15. I said earlier that any number that ends with 5 or 0 is a multiple of 5. Any number that ends with 5 or 0 is a multiple of 5. You can see this ends with 5 and this ends with 0. So having said that, we can now divide 2 by 5. 5 into 15 will give us 3. 5 into 12, we have 2 remainder 2. It now becomes 20. 5 into 20 is 4. 5 into 0, we have 0. So we now have 240 over 3. 3 into itself is 1. 3 into 24 is 8, and 0, we have 0. 80 divided by 1, we have 80. So our answer is 80. Okay, let's look at these few examples. A bag of yams holds 2.5 kilograms. I take out 600 grams. How much does the bag now weigh? The second one says, how much must be added to 130 grams to make 2 kilograms, 35 grams? We begin with the first. A bag of yams holds 2.5 kilograms. We take out 600 grams. How much does the bag now weigh? You want to see that we have different units. So we convert them to one unit, preferably the small unit. So we know that 1 kilogram is 1,000 grams. We now convert our kilograms to grams. So this is the higher unit and this is the smaller one. So we say 2.5 kilograms to grams. We say 2.5 times 1,000 grams. About kilograms to grams multiplied by 1,000, and this is a mixed number. We convert to improper fraction. 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1, we have 5 over 2 times 1,000 grams. 2 into itself is 1. Into 10 we have 5. 0 we have 0 and 0. We now have 5 times 500 grams. 5 times 500, we multiply, we get 2,500 grams. Multiply 5 by 500. So we now have about 2.5 kilograms in grams to be 2,500 grams. We can now see how a bag of yam holds 2,500 grams. We take out 600 grams. How much does the background weigh? We take out, as we take away, what it means is this minus 600. Take away this minus, we have 2,500 grams minus 600 grams. If we subtract, let's see, 2,500 minus 600. We have our grams. 0 minus 0, we have 0. 0. 5 minus 6, now possibly borrow 1. Here's maybe 1. 15 minus 6, we have 9. We bring down 1. We have 1,900 grams. That's 1,900 grams. That's our final answer. We can as well convert it to kilograms if we wish. We can as well convert to kilograms. And we know that from kilograms to grams we multiply by 1,000, but from grams to kilograms we divide by 1,000. We have 1,900 all over 1,000. It's 2 zeros, we cancel these 2. But then with 19 over 10. Since it has 1 0, we move 1 step towards the left because of the 1 0. So that will give us 1.9 kilograms. So I said earlier on, in converting from gram to kilogram, to divide by 1,000. So let us take a brief recap. A bag of yams holds this figure. We take away 600 grams. How much does the bag now weigh? We say since we have seen that there are different units, we convert them to one unit, preferably the smaller unit. So in conversion of this 2.5 kilograms to grams, we multiply by 1,000. That we did to get 2,500 grams. So 2.5 kilograms is equivalent to 2,500 grams. So we now subtract 600 from 2,500 grams. We get 1,900 grams. This is our final answer. But we can as well convert to kilograms by dividing by 1,000, and in doing so we get 1.9 kilograms. So either this, you can stop here or solve for that to get this. Either of them is correct. So that is how to subtract this, how to solve for this. That's our final answer, 1.9 kilograms or 1,900 grams. How much must be added to 130 grams to make 2 kilograms, 35 grams? How much must be added to 130 grams to make 2 kilograms, 35 grams? Okay, since we have 2 kilograms, 35 grams, we convert it to grams. So, we say 2 kilograms, 35 grams to grams. We convert our 2 kilograms to grams. That will give us, let's say 2 kilograms to grams, we say 2 times 1,000 grams. And that will give us 2,000 grams. So, 2 kilograms, 35 grams will give us 2,000 grams plus 35 grams. This is like saying 2 kilograms plus 35 grams. Since we have established that 2 kilograms is 2,000 grams, so we now say 2,000 grams plus 35 grams. If we add that, this will give us 2,035 grams. Let's see, 2,000 plus 35. 0 plus 5, we have 5. 0 plus 3, we have 3. We bring down 0 and 2. So we have 2,035 grams. So our 2 kilograms, 35 grams is equivalent to 2,035 grams. We have to ask how much must be added to 130 grams to get this. So for us to get that, we subtract 2,035 grams minus 130 grams. 2,035 grams minus 130 grams. 5 minus 0, we have 5. 3 minus 3, we have 0. 0 minus 1, we borrow 1. And 1 is left. 10 minus 1 is 9. And we bring down 1. So we have 1,905 grams left. We have 1,905 grams left. We can as well convert it to kilograms. We can as well convert to kilograms. We know that 1,000 kilograms is 1,000 grams is 1 kilogram. So we can say, okay, 1,000 grams we know is 1 kilogram. And if you take 1,000 from here, we are left with 905 grams. We can write our answer as 1 kilogram, 905 grams. The reason I'm writing the answer this way is because it helps in all fear. We have 2 kilograms, 35 grams. So I can decide to write the answer this way, 1 kilogram, 905 grams. Okay, let's take a brief recap again. How much will be added to 130 grams to make 2 kilograms, 35 grams? And we said, since we have different units, we convert all to the smaller units. So we convert this to grams. 3 kilograms to grams give us 2 times 1,000 grams, which will give us 2,000 grams. So 2 kilograms, 35 grams, it is simply like saying 2 kilograms plus 35 grams. So 2 kilograms is now 2,000 grams. So you now say 2,000 grams plus 35 grams. Since these two are equal, we add this to get 2,035 grams. We now subtract. Subtract 130 from this. 130 from the question. So we subtract 130. 5 minus 0, we have 5. 3 minus 3, we have 0. 0 minus 1 is not possible. We borrow 1 to add here, and 1 is now left. Here becomes 10. 10 minus 1, we have 9. And we bring down our 1. So we now have 1,905 grams as our answer. But I just decided that since our question we have 2 kilograms 35 grams, we should express our answer in that form. This is actually correct, but we can always suffer to express our answer in this form, the way it came from the question. So 1,000 grams, we know already is 1 kilogram. And if we take out 1,000 here, we are left with 905 grams. So we now have 1 kilogram, 905 grams as our final answer. With that, we have come to the end of the class for today. I will not be giving you any other assignment because I have given you so many assignments which I have not seen from some of you. Although some of you have been responding, but a good number of you have not been doing so. So I want to urge you to do all the assignments and submit as soon as you can. See you next week. Stay safe and be good to children. Goodbye.